Hi, let me introduce VJOYCAR V60. This is the gift box. This is the install tool. This is the OBD cable and the 16 pin. This is the holder. This is the user manual. Let me show it with our testing tool. Okay, this is the new device with both OBD and GPS chipset. This is a light sensor. This is the micro USB port. In case your car doesn't have OBD port or you just want to use your GPS model, then you can use the micro USB 2 USB cable and plug the device to your car adapter or car USB port on your car. It's a modern device with two interfaces. This little interface can show the local time because we are on the testing tour, so it only shows the zero. This is the lighting bar. It can be blue, red, and white. Default is blue. When device has an alarm, it will be red. If you don't need it, you can turn it off, then it will be white. And when the device is off, it's white also. This is the three button, left, right, OK. This is the main button. If you click the button, you can switch the interface. This device has 10 interfaces. Let me show you. 9 interface. This is the classic interface, and this one, most of our clients like this interface also. And this little function you can change. If you click this button, you can change this icon and choose it. This is the oil temperature. You can switch it. If I want to modify this RPM, if you don't know what does the icon mean, you can check the user manual. For example, this is the coolant temperature. This is oil temperature, RPM. And then you change it to the default. This is a fuel consumption, okay? This is voltage. And let me show you when the value change, what happened on the device. Let me change the speed, the driving speed first of all. Speed alarm. Okay, let me change the RPM. This is the RPM value. And this RPM bar also. Let me change the coolant water temperature. Okay, this is a coolant water temperature. Okay. Let me turn it off. But I know it's a lie, what you keep inside. Now let me show the setting. If you long press the menu button, long press. It has kinds of settings. This is speed setting, RPM setting, fuel setting, turbo setting, time setting, general setting. Okay, go back to speed setting. If you click speed setting, you can see speed adjust, speed alarm, speed limit. And if you think the device speed is not very acute, or you want to a bit high or a bit lower than the real speed, you can change it by hand. And then also important, you can change the speed unit. The default speed unit is kmh, because in China we use this. You can change it to mph also. This is kmh, mph. Long press, come back. RPM. One click, OK button. RPM alarm. Long press, OK button, come back. Fuel. You can change the fuel unit. Okay. Long press, OK button. Turbo. One click. Turbo unit. As usual, it can get the local time directly. In case any mistake, you can change the time zone by yourself. And the most important function is rest alarm. Default is 4 hours. You can change it to 5 or 3, like this. This is the 40 driving alarm. Seat unit. This is the general setting. General setting, you can modify the coolant alarm, voltage alarm, and the most important is the brightness. The device has a brightness sensor here, so it can know the device is at daytime or at night. However, you can change it by hand also. And as I told you at the beginning, the device has both OBD and the GPS chipset, right? Default is OBD system, because OBD can show many functions. In case your car doesn't have OBD port, or your car OBD2 protocol is not open, is not public, then your car may be not compatible with our OBD device, then you can turn OBD switch to off. Then device will come back to GPS working system. Let me try, okay. Okay, now it will come to GPS working system. Thank you. If you have any question, please let us know. Thank you. Bye-bye.